Hey friends, guess what we're doing today? We're tackling a project which I've been procrastinating for a little bit too long, so it really needs to be taken care of today. And that is the horizontal netting as support for my cut flowers. So typically I install this pretty quick after I planted them out. Didn't have much time to do that, and the weather wasn't very much helping there either. We had a lot of rain. I'm actually recording this between rain showers. I know it doesn't look like rain, but it's supposed to thunderstorm later on today, so we got to make sure that we get that in before that happens. But what do I use typically as netting is some polyester net is the name, and I'll link everything below as well. It's from Vivusan. It's not Hordenova netting, which you might have heard of, which a lot of professional growers use as well. That for some reason never worked out for me in the horizontal application. Finally, it works very well in the vertical one. My peas loving it and growing up on it without any issues. And it's holding up strong. But when I had it in the beds horizontally, like the connections were breaking too easily when I was just reaching in. And even when I was careful, like I was not like, I don't know, karate chopping into it or something weird like that. So yeah. But yeah, we got to get that going today. I have still a few hoops from the covers I had in here, which I have to take out, and then we'll use just the normal T-post to weasel it around. This netting is a little bit wider than my beds are, so I'll make sure I have one side properly aligned, and then on the other side I cut the remaining material off with a very sharp scissor that is usually fairly quick. It will be interesting, as a few plants are already taller. We even have some dahlia buds already. Well, on two plants out of 50, so you're not behind. Those are just overachievers, but everything else, yeah, starts to get size up, so we really need to get that netting in place. And typically what I do is I install this on the third knob of the T-post. I'll show you that in a little bit detail as well. So yeah, let's get going here. So what I typically do is I'll take it out and try to lay it out alongside the field. It just takes a little bit of patience, and you can see here it's not super wide. It's like 5 feet wide, so just 2 feet longer than my beds are deep. So we'll cut some off, but I'll just move it along here. All right, now the fiddly part starts, where we unfold it, find the beginning properly. I think there we go. And as I mentioned, it's wider than I needed to, so I always try to have one side proper and the other side overhanging, so that I only have to cut on one side. As it's easier for me to cut on the outside, I'll make sure the inside of the bed is the proper side. And first I just put it loosely over, especially when I have already tall ones like the armies over there. Again, ideally you do that when everything is small. That is the easiest way to do it. And then you just have a lot of patience, unravel it nicely. The T-posts make it actually quite easy to put over. The middle one are a little bit trickier this year, but we added them for extra stability for the dahlias, because last year they were flopping. So always aim for a little bit of tension. 2, 3, 4, 5. Here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. It can go one more. 6. Okay. And then I basically just work them down step by step. I'm not sure we will get that quite closed down as much as I wanted, because the plants are already so big without like disturbing them too much, but we'll definitely try. Yeah, the fencing around it does make it easy either, but the bunnies have been terrible this year, so I'm keeping it up until everything has a size and is not so tasty anymore. So let me see how we can get you. No idea Ami can get so big. The first time growing it for me, but it looks like it's pretty and very close to flowering. They are quite flexible, so I think they will be fine. Might do a triangle or so here, or a nod to keep that all tight before I go this way. Yeah, something like that. That is the netting. We'll do the same way over there. And if I have the energy left, we'll do the same in the other bed, but that has a little bit more time because we just planted the summer crops there. Yeah, my procrastination. It's really hot and humid today, so I'm already like dripping sweat. So, and the camera is not liking the heat either. So you gotta be fast. Some really sharp scissors to make the job a lot easier too. There we go. And don't let them leave in the sun. They are burning hot. Ah. And if you're wondering where Maggie is hiding in temperatures like this, you will not find her outside until the evening. That is too hot for her. So, and here's the other side done. It's a little bit of an eyesore, I know, but it's really necessary for your plants to have the support they need. Otherwise, you're heartbroken if they're flopping around and are really not happy with where they're at and how the wind bounces them around. So I think I'm going to cool down inside. I'm so sweaty. So I think I'll leave it as is. I'll cut out the edge later when it's not so hot. I'm like sweating. But yeah, this is the support for my dahlias and most of the cut flowers, how I keep it for most of the season. And then typically for the dahlias, once they are like high like that, or tall like that, I will also use some twine between the T-posts to build another grid for them to like not like flop over into the garden either. And that worked very well last year, so I don't do a second row of netting or so. That's too much of a hassle for me later on with like getting the cut flowers harvested, etc. So for that reason, I only do one layer of netting, and then wherever we need more, with some twines around the T-post. So it was more tactical or operational video here again, but I hope it was interesting to you. I have all the materials I used linked in the description, so check that one out. Yeah, and let me know how you support your dahlias. I'm always looking forward to hear from other ones how they treat those large, heavy plants at the end of the season. And yeah, subscribe and watch another video. Thank you.